Welcome to Middle Farm, situated in an area of outstanding natural beauty, deep in the Shropshire Hills. Covering 32 acres of woodland, pasture, and even a fishing lake, Middle Farm is not just a small holding, it's my way of life. Unless you're born into this lifestyle, becoming a smallholder takes time and practice. It is definitely something you evolve into, almost without realising. The understanding that you are the custodians of a sizeable plot of land takes several months to come to terms with, then only a few more after that to realise you could do with three times the amount of space. Christmas presents change from classy clothes to boiler suits, expensive wellies become a worthwhile investment, as shoes become obsolete.
I first met Sam after she asked if I'd join a team of chefs to cook on a local BBC radio show, working with the seasonal veg grown at Middle Farm and the British luck pork that she breeds there. The series, quite aptly named, Lot to Pot. This was a chance for me to taste the British luck pork for the first time, and wow, the quality of the meat and the fat was amazing. Plus, Sam's passion and enthusiasm for rearing the UK's rarest breed inspired a whole new range of dishes at the restaurant and gave us a newer, clearer perspective on the pork we were buying, and it resulted in me getting a new supplier.
But in fairness, most people opt for things like the loin, the shoulder.
I see, but I like the loin. But I want the, I know, yeah. You don't like the loin very much.
The loin's great for baking. But I want the...
You want the shoulder and the legs.
I want the belly. That's what I want. You want that.
Fat.
And crackling.
Basically, fat and crackling. Yeah, but you can get crackling. Great, amazing crackling on loin. I will cook you loin one day, roasted the way I roast it. And it is unbelievable.
It's amazing. the moisture thing with that though, isn't it?
Yeah, but you can always cook it. You can cook it the same as you do any other solid meat. You can cook it in a liquid, you can cook it in,
a water bath.
No, I meant cider. It's not a water bath. No, cider or any stock of any kind, really. Just make sure you keep that cracking there.
Yeah. So that's where the water bath has to come. Too many scientific chefy things.
Amazing.
Hate peppers. Yeah, I don't know why, but we will use it in our huevos ranchero.
Oh.
Has she eaten it all?
Only one.
You make my hands really go.
But look, they've got no seeds either. Great. Not great for the variety, but it's good.
Yeah.
Nice.
That's sweet, though. Mm.
With a bit of basil.
Mm.
A bit of tomato. In fact, actually, I'll tell you what, you use stuff, I don't even know, you know, I grow it, like the kohlrabi, I cannot wait to see. Have you picked that? Oh no, haven't
picked
that yet.
No, I haven't picked the kohlrabi yet. Mm. That's going to be fabulous, isn't it? But these tomatoes, they are amazing. I like these, I know you didn't like them, but...
No, they are really nice, but they are unique to Sutton seeds. Can't buy them anywhere
colour.
Else. Yeah, they're called Firecracker. I like the name, I thought. Cool.
Mm, they look really
cool. Really good, and they look really good.
Have you tried one of the green ones?
No. Have you?
No. Let's try a green one.
I don't really eat green tomatoes very much. They're good in chutneys, aren't they?
But not that one, I mean the greeny yellow one. Mm. We'll try that. Because actually these are lovely. Salted and fried.
Oh, look at that.
Yeah, look at that. But they're quite hard, obviously. But they're nice with the, like.
They're really nice.
They're really nice with pecorino or.
Oh, they're really nice.
Mm.
They're packed with flavour, aren't they?
Because it's not super sweet.
Not sweet at all, actually. But it is nice.
I really like them.
Yeah, they're good.
Oh, God. You didn't like that one. No, like these firecracker ones. So we'll use those. I like these little cherry ones as well. I thought they were really tasty.
Much sweeter, aren't they?
Yeah.
Oh, I love these.
I love it how buffalo mozzarella or burrata starts when you tear it. I think you need to get some buffaloes and we'll make some. She thinks I'm joking. Okay, so we've got our spring onions that I'm looking for my oil. Put my oil. That's it. You want that charred, lovely flavour you get from onions, and it just adds more texture. See how they're going flimsy now? They're beautiful and soft and confident inside because they're just basically steamed. What I like to do is take these and put them in a plastic tub with the top on them. And just let them steam and soften. Just put it in there. Start to assemble it. I'll leave that there. And I did some cucumber earlier, some of that fabulous cucumber you gave me. Now this is really, really light.
I think the sesame.
Just add a little. So it's all about texture.
Is that in the same
That's in Miri. And there you go, perfectly softened now. It only takes like a couple of minutes. Caprese. But a different caprese.
Growing piglets on the farm comes with the same ups and downs as raising kids. Sweet to look at, but born to test the boundaries. Naughty, curious, welly-nibbling monsters that always seem to win the hearts of any farm visitor.
Sorry, I can't hear you. 2 seconds. Sorry?
Upturned sods in the garden and black faces are a sure sign explorations have been taken to the next stage. Many piglets have nuzzled their way under the barbed wire and escaped into fields or other pig pens, and even interrupted guests having a cosy barbecue under the byre. Always hungry though, Mum's grubs up grunting call has them galloping back under the wire in no time at all.
I think they're back in now.
Okay. Okay. Are you doing that now?
I'm going to do it from the other side of the scale and then call her and hope that she comes.
Do you want me to come with you?
Mabel!
Okay.
Mabel!
Check the zoo. Mabel! Right behind
you. Come on! Yep, you shut the gate one. You've got there, haven't you?
Mabel!
Come on, Mabel!
Come on, Mabel!
Come on! Have you shut that one?
After a gestation period of 3 months, 3 weeks, and 3 days, followed by the obligatory 3 glasses of wine to celebrate, there is nothing quite like welcoming new life to remind us of why we value it so much. It is always a considerable privilege to sit with a sow in labour and my first experience of this was with our favourite Mabel, who ended up having 14 little monsters. She taught us that pigs do make nests before giving birth, and this is indeed a sign that tiny trotters are on their way. We celebrated new life, an arcane glimpse of it at its most vulnerable and most perfect for the first time. Mabel continues to be an incredible mother and extraordinarily gentle sow.
Spring onion, and then let's see what the pig farmer thinks of her pig.
Thank you very much. Ooh, look at this. Oh. Mm. That is beautiful. Very, very good.
Very Moorish.
Oh, these are great.
Rob Swift.
Beautiful.
All the way from Ludlow. So in essence, apart from the whist, everything's from Shropshire. How's the pork?
This is beautiful. Really, we're going to start massing some of these.
Looks like I've only 1,500.
We always found chickens easy to look after and maintain. Whilst we avoid giving them meat products, they eat most of the scraps from the kitchen, vegetable peelings, uneaten sandwich crusts and leftover pasta, to name but a few. If they do spot you carrying a bowl outside, they'll assume it's for them and run at great speed to make sure they don't miss out on the day's treats.
See, that's why I think it's perfect for bacon and not for, I'm going to lard this off, by the way. Emmental. That would certainly spice it up.
Yeah.
Yeah. Lovely. Black pudding, bacon, sausage, hoisin ketchup. Gotta have cheese. Not the same without the cheese. That would be wow. Sambals. Bacon sambals.
Bacon sambals.
That's the bun. 3 and a half. Actually, for a cheeky squeeze of Japanese.
Japanese.
Which is Middle Eastern. Oh, double yoga.
Oh, super. You never know what you're going
to
get on a farm.
There we go. So is our grill sufficient? Yes, it is. There we go. I think this is ready, Sam.
Okay.
That really is doing it on Wellies. I'm starving.
Oh my god, this looks amazing.
And there's also a little bit of Mexican in there. But I kind of get the Mediterranean thing. But what a great,
This way of life is not about instant gratification. It does require good foundations, patience, and hard work. But in return, it not only fulfills many empty voids left by modern day living, but it teaches us new and far more valuable skills. Although many friends and guests suggest that they too would love to live this life, they are less attracted by the enduring work involved. I can understand that shifting piles of muck, handling farm animals both dead and alive, lugging 25 kilo bags of feed around whilst permanently clad in tatty clothes and wellies, is not everyone's idea of good living. Personally, I find it a great privilege, albeit hard work, to spend my days in this way. It is not a job. There is no clock off time or weekend break. It is a way of life, a life that requires good health, an inordinate amount of self-motivation. The diversity of the things to do is extensive enough to keep even the most easily bored out of trouble. This includes me, being able to switch from finances and marketing to shoveling manure and collecting pig carcasses makes every day extraordinary. I understand that many good smallholders start off inspired by the same dream. After years of commuting to work through relentless traffic, making do with processed sandwiches for lunch, endless meetings about targets, results, and ironically personal development, it's not hard to understand how and why so many of us become disenchanted with our everyday business. It does seem a little extreme to jack it all in for a life looking after animals and growing your own food. But for all the different reasons, be they independence, fine-tuning survival skills, or just wanting more space and being more connected to nature in our otherwise hectic existence, I can say with experience that for me, the reality has surpassed the dream.
Sand on toes, coats hanging, sleeping bags. I come to know that memories were the best things you ever had. The summer shorn, beat down on bony backs, so far from home where the ocean stood, down dust and pine cones.